back for Sharp. Taze waits, down low. Kane tried to step it in. Rebound in front. And he headbutted the puck into the net. The referees are going to meet.
Referees right now trying to determine whether the intentional soccer style header is a legal goal. Andrew Shaw, unbelievable. Puck bounces up in the air, Kane goes around. Now watch Andrew Shaw. Sees it, jumps, and heads it absolutely on purpose. Look at this. Oh, and into the net. This happens, I don't know if I've ever seen an intentional.
I've never seen it
hit guy's head. I recall once Stu Grimson got hit in the head on a rebound. But I don't know if I've ever seen the intentional direction like that from Andrew Shaw. All those pre-game warm-up soccer games paying off.
Person deliberately headbutted the puck in the net, no goal.
Here's the play. Anderson makes the save. Now, the skate of the Boston player did touch the goal.
There it is.
Boy, it's hard to call.
That's going to be interesting. That is going to be a very interesting call. Did the first player, the question will be, hit Anderson enough so that he did not allow him to make that second save because he was taken out of the play by the initial contact? That is what they're trying to decide right now between the officials and Toronto. Let's have another look. So, is this play here enough to put Anderson out of the play so that he cannot do his job in the net to make that rebound attempt?
We have to make something clear here. The referee had made the announcement that the goal was under review.
Correct, Bob. So, in other words, the referee on the ice deemed this no goal. So it has to be conclusive to be overturned to be a good goal.
They looked at it carefully. They said no goal.
And you can see the reaction from the bench. They think they got a goal.
Reviewing the play, and the call on the ice stands, and we have no goal.
You don't have to say anything more. They're playing on. There is no goal.
McDavid gets by Monahan. Now against Gaudreau. McDavid stopped by Riddick. Second chance. Strome scores. Ryan Strome, overtime winner.
Connor McDavid gets the puck, and he is absolutely gone. And on that play, all you got to do is follow up Connor McDavid, because that's where the puck is going to be. Connor with the strong move to the net. Opportunity for the rebound, and Ryan Strome follows it up perfectly. I think maybe they're looking at, as Connor McDavid comes through the net, the stick of the goaltender, David Riddick, kind of follows Connor. Connor's foot hits it.
The play is under review.
So Connor comes in. As he drives in, he gets the chance on net. And see, as he drags his skate, that hits the stick of Riddick.
After video review with the Situation Room in Toronto, has determined there is goaltender interference. We have no goal.
Wow.
I don't understand that call.
Look at it here, 1.4 right there. Let's run it. The puck is heading towards the net. Oh. Oh. Oh, we got a close one here. Look at that. The puck is on the wrong side of the goal line.
I tell you, that is close as you're ever going to see, Jonesy. And the San Jose Sharks bench did not move. Their coach, they didn't believe for a second. They all looked up. They said there's no goal there because they had looked at that and said it couldn't have been a goal.
Well, they're pretty sharp, Steve-O, because that looked like a little close.
I looked at the clock and saw 0.2 seconds.
I know.
So the clock on the scoreboard wasn't in sync with the clock we just showed you. That is amazing.
Well, that is amazing because they all looked up and they just kind of shook their heads. Obviously, they were a little optimistic at that time, but you can see that this puck just is ahead.
Here's the call.
The
review of the goal. Time had expired before the puck completely crossed the goal line. No goal.
All right. We go to a shootout.
And Franzi. Datsyuk watched by Myers to Zetterberg. Scores! With Franzen in front, they're waving it off. Oh, we've seen this too many times already this year. Abdelkader, when Datsyuk had scored in Montreal, the phantom callback of the Miller goal on a Glendening penalty. And now this one's being waved off. Graham Skilleter will give us the reason as to why.
Number 93 for Detroit, establishes the position in the goal crease, no goal.
Are his feet in the crease? That's the question. If he's in the blue, you're the goaltender.
And if he's in the blue, the way they're calling it nowadays, and they're calling that no goal, and
yep.
Franzen's body is completely
he's in the crease.
Inside the blue.
Yep.
Nerver didn't sell it like Carey Price sold it.
No, but they didn't call a penalty, just no goal and incidental contact, so.
Roddy Smith, he'll feed the point. Another drive on the way, goes down, and he scores! But as you can see from that Sharks bench, nobody is left. And they intend to have this looked at. This is not a challenge situation, but they are looking at this one for potential goaltender interference.
Relentless pressure here on this forecheck. What a pickpocket by Smith. He steals the puck. Backhand sauce to Theodore. And he doesn't try and rip it. He gets it down into the danger zone. And a great job to find the loose puck. Layers of screens in front of Martin Jones. And right there, the backhand by Marchessault. And what they're wondering is Marchessault, when he comes through, leans in a little bit. Right there on Martin Jones. Catches him in the blocker as he's pushing through with Dillon. And we'll see what they say.
Wow. The mic doesn't work, so Eric Furlatt says you make the announcement. Kelly Sutherland.
After situation room review, it's determined there is goaltender interference. Prior to the goal, no goal.
And we play on in Vegas.